There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved. They came through stormy black seas. They raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. To these gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. You fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home. Sword still beats a heart. The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender. Abandon and to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Hello there, guys. Welcome back to part 3 of Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. Thanks for checking in. And we're starting this one on our way to Helheim. And we start like this.
The gods made you a warrior for a war. It's your call.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a reversal. When there is a new world ahead, let's crush on them. I got this. These guys again. Oh, big deal.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
You can parry him. Alright, he does his charge attack. We can flank him. Nope. This is hitting me. Shit. Let's see what you do about that, fucker. Oh. Yeah, I'm messing it totally. Yeah, I try to be more offensive, but that's my problem, actually. Well, that's a little one. Ooh, yeah. I heard him from the 3D sound system. I could block him. Well, these guys just appear out of nowhere. This is I wasn't expecting this. Just to heal up a little bit. I'm kinda cold right now. I saw that one coming to me, but I was still on the animation. Oh. shield, God. I really hate these ones more than the larger ones. Oh, sorry, I'm kinda sleepy. Another stone.
However you come to the gold covered bridge that leads to hell, you may find it guarded by
symbols on the door of course.
She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rose.
I can see that extractor maybe from. Yeah, the hint is over here. So, is. Yeah, that's it. And just always be aware of the hints. That's the door I came in. What else? Okay. Oh yeah, that seemed weird from over there. Okay, you need to see it from here to materialize it. Now we have the stairs. We're missing two symbols right now, and I see a hint already, so it could be around this area with the things hanging in the center. I don't see it, but let's go upstairs. Oh, the symbol changed, but oh, it's right there. Okay, now I'm going to go back and search for the S. Hopefully it's over here. Okay, yeah. There we go. I cannot drop from here. I wonder what's that for, but not really stopping it.
Possesses large dwelling places in Helheim.
Oh, and that's the iron door there. Was just beside the
name of her dish
symbol one.
Is hunger. Her knife is famine.
Mm-hmm.
On her threshold, all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize. Half black.
It's coming. This is your moment.
Oh shit. This is gonna be hella fun.
I'm sorry.
Alright. About the woman. Weakness.
You're not a warrior. You're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Hell is reaching deep inside of her. Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? World shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you. Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just like your sword.
Come on. There.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask?
Well, this is starting to look really crazy to me. It doesn't make any sense, but it's just on the mind.
Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. Song.
It's not real. It's true. It's not real. It's real. Listen to it.
She can't give up.
Daddy. It's
not like this.
It's not real. It's real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in yourself?
Let's carry on then. Nothing here.
before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
And we have one of those faces, one more of them. Let's hear what it has to say.
There will be times that you will feel alone and exhausted, like a strange little fish swimming against the tides of the big ocean. But have the faith to let go and let the tide carry you away. Because the whole ocean is your home, and it does not ask you to swim against it.
It's already disappeared.
Nothing lives here, not even you. It's in your mind. You think you can see it, but it's in your mind.
There's the tree.
There he was. The lone figure of a boy.
He's there, under the tree.
Swordplay under the shade of a tree. She remembers the first time she saw him.
He's there, under the tree.
To her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. The gloom lifted. For the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to... Death for Sigmund and his brother seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel...
Day after day, watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret dance, wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last forever.
It's a trick. It's an illusion. It's not real.
She could do the same. see the world through eyes anew and dance with it, just like he does.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
You killed him.
But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
You want to believe it.
Is he there?
Not real.
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Delia?
Nothing lives here.
You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign of the tree.
What's the tree to tell you?
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break. And he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like a... Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest.
I'm just checking. Come on, no big deal.
It's a dream. It's a dream.
happening?
Senua, imagine a sword that can slay gods. Its name is Gramr. It was forged by the god of all Northmen, Odin, and gifted to Sigmund, a great warrior.
I need this sword. It's important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gramr by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the tree of death.
Yeah, it's obvious you need to go to those shiny shards, I think they are. But yeah. Yeah, it's so simple, you see? You don't have to do all that deal about it.
King in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now?
Burial mound.
So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. We have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword.
Dillian, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
There he is. There he is. Dillian,
there he is.
Finally, you found him.
What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me? Just wait there. I'll find you.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Don't touch the walls.
You don't know what they might do.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can save you.
It's too scary.
I can hear him.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
Find another way. It's not working.
You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find another
think.
Way.
Think. Think. Focus.
It's not here. It's not here.
We told you. We told you it was a trick. Doesn't sound like Dillian.
What's happening?
It's not him, it can't be.
What's that sound? The voice is changing.
What? That's not Dillian.
That doesn't
in there.
What's in there?
What is it?
A secret room.
There are bars.
How do you get in there?
How does she get in there?
Hervor ignores her father's warnings. The grave mound opens, and it seems to be full of fire. Again, Hervor demands her inheritance. But her father warns her that the sword is cursed and would be the bane of her family. But he relents and brings her the sword. She leaves the island with it, but the curse holds true, and death would follow in the years to come. And so, Senua, the misdeeds of a father have cursed his daughter.
It's not Dillian. Wants me to face my fears. I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief had son.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you, they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!